Welcome back to another episode of the Switch Survival Guide. Today I am really excited because I'm going to show you how to build this ridiculous base that is essentially floating 6 stories up in the air. Now this is too high for a Tyrannosaur to even reach, and it's designed to lure any big dinosaur that attacks it to just fall off the cliff and be totally harmless while we shoot it down from below. So this is a pretty cool design. It's got some risks associated with it, but I will teach you how to build this, and it should actually be really fun for the rest of our journey. Now, I'm going to start out here right next to my thatch house on the end of this little peninsula. Now, if you missed some of my earlier episodes, we started out on starting zone 1, which is the default first place that it offers, and most people start here. Now, if you follow this little inlet of water all the way to the end, you can see there's these two cliffs at the very end of that, and those two cliffs are going to be a perfect spot to build our base. Hey, an otter, not bad. That'll be very helpful later on. So if you are playing on PvE, this is a pretty good base configuration, but if you're playing a PvP server, do not build this base, trust me. It's designed to trick the AI of dinosaurs to fall off the cliff if they attack you, but people are not quite so stupid, and if you're playing on PvP, a person's just gonna drop a little C4 on your pillar, and your entire base will come crashing down all at once. So if you're doing PvP, this area that I'm facing right now, to the right of this area, has a nice flat section. It's right under the jungle. And that's not a bad place to build if you're on a PvP server. So keep that in mind. Now, this section right here is very flat, and it's going to be ideal for building the base foundation of our base. And then we'll use some of those wooden pillars to just build straight up and kind of have it suspended above this section right here. This is a great spot to build because it's right next to the forest. There are tons of lumber. We can just harvest all of these trees and clear out the forest over here. And it also has this higher step, which we can use to get our dinosaurs up really high and then walk over to the roof of our base, which is where I'm planning to keep them. Now, this section over here is great if you want to just make a really simple wooden base and just have something really easy. If you watched my episode 5, I explained how to make a simple base design using thatch, and you can actually just expand upon that if you want to build something simple out of wood. But somewhere on the top of these flat cliffs is not a bad place to build because it's still pretty easy to lure dinosaurs to fall off the cliff, and that's a great way to defend your base. So we may run into some predators up here. The open area next to that forest is, reasonably dangerous. There's probably going to be some strong stuff spawning, but we're going to build this base to handle that and just lure them to fall right off the cliff. So before we start, we just unlocked the wood tier, and we can start building wooden houses, which are much stronger than thatch. I wouldn't even bother building a base that's any decent size with thatch because it's so easy for a dinosaur to break that. Wood is a good bit more durable, and it'll take a lot more damage before your base collapses. So I'm just going to set up the engram for wooden foundations because we need to make a bunch, and we'll just go super fast as I'm gathering a bunch of wood, thatch, and fiber from this forest nearby. And we'll basically be skipping most of the gathering because you already know how to do that. So let me go ahead and get this foundation in my hotbar, and I want to start building on the very edge of the cliff. And I'm going to find a nice flat area. It doesn't look like it's going up or down as I'm sliding it around. So I'm going to stand on the very edge and aim it directly down this way. And I'm looking up and down, and as you can see, that foundation just slides nicely back and forth. Foundations will snap in a very straight line, so if we had this crooked towards the left, the foundations actually wouldn't be able to snap, further down the line. So I want to make sure I do a nice clear line along the edge of this cliff. And since this cliff gets narrower in this direction, this will actually put it closer to the top of that other cliff so that we can build a nice little walkway to get up to the top of our base. So I'm back here. We've added a couple more foundations, and I'm going to start building some support pillars heading up about 5 stories, which will keep them away from even the range of a T-Rex. A T-Rex is about 4 stories tall, and if you get that 5th story up, then he's pretty unlikely to be able to attack your base. 6 stories high is definitely going to be safe. So I've got these pillars up really high, but I'm not actually going to be able to reach them very likely. So I'm going to go ahead and make a thatch ceiling and see if we can attach it to the top of that 5th story. But if we can't, we're going to have to start building from the top of that cliff, which is one of the big reasons I selected this location. It's going to be much easier to build this design. So let's just see how this goes. Now, if you can't reach something, sometimes jumping will get it a little bit higher, but as you can see, we still can't quite get up to that 5-story high mark, even by jumping. So we're gonna have to extend these foundations. Also, check that out. That is a Tapehara. It is an incredibly good flying dinosaur. It's like a pteranodon, but it's way better. They are very rare, so if you ever see one, it's a great idea to try to tame it. But we're not going to be able to tame that guy without tranquilizer darts or, trank arrows. So I'm not going to bother with that just this second. So I'm going to start extending this walkway towards the cliff, but you can see we've got this little dip in the rock. And we're going to have to improvise a little bit to make the support structure able to continue. So the episode before this, I showed you how to build on uneven ground, so definitely go back and watch that if you haven't seen it yet. It's going to be very helpful while you're building a base. So I'm going to use some wooden ceilings and some wooden pillars to be able to extend this even across uneven ground. Now sometimes a wooden pillar will snap from one side of the foundation to the other, but it's not snapping properly here, which means it's just a little too far down. So I'm going to snap a ceiling off of this side, and we can build 2 ceilings over before we start losing our support. But I can also put a pillar directly through the middle of this ceiling, and then we can extend that down into the ground. And as soon as that pillar hits the ground, there we go, that is now going to count as basically as good as a foundation. Now we're going to start building these pillars up and see if we can get them to the top of that cliff face, and then we'll start building from the top of there once we get them high enough. Another really good reason to have 2 support pillars is if some kind of a dinosaur were to manage to break the pillar on my right-hand side, and that was the only pillar holding up the base, the entire base would come crashing down. Once you break the connection from the floor to the ceiling, anything in between will actually just break. So I've kind of went over some of the physics on that in the episode before this, so definitely watch that if you're going to do something like this, because you need to kind of understand the dynamics. But if we have pillars attached on both sides, then it's okay even if a predator breaks one of those sets of pillars, because the other one will still hold up the base. So it's definitely good to have a backup plan. All right, so we've got 2 sets of pillars extended up, and as you can see, the foundations have an unbroken chain. They are all totally even and connected to each other. So now I'm going to head up to the top and see if we can start laying some ceilings on our 6th floor and start building out from here. And that will actually allow us to reach the other pillar that we're trying to build towards. So I'm a little bit too heavy to move. Going to drop off some materials here. And let's see how we're doing. Now, I got really unlucky. If you're building this, build just a little bit further to the right, because this rock is totally in the way. But I think, great, I can get down there without actually falling to my death. So actually, on second thoughts, that's kind of helpful to have this little bit of a ledge right here. It's going to let me get a little closer. So now I'm going to head back up to the top and see if I can reach the top of that pillar from the top of this cliff. Sorry for all the running around, but this is kind of a difficult and tedious process at first, but once we have this foundation together, this is going to be amazing. So now I'm going to just hop on here, hopefully not fall to my death, and see if we can reach the top of this. Now, a couple episodes ago, I showed you how to make water flasks, and basically, This is the main reason that happened. I'm going to have to keep running back and forth to the water in order to keep from dying of dehydration up here in the jungle because it's really hot up here. Also, if you look down next to the beach, there is something really cool. It's kind of hard to catch. There it is. That is a tech parasaur. Now, it is a very low chance that any parasaur that spawns will be a tech parasaur. And it's basically the exact same thing as a regular parasaur, only it looks flippin' awesome. It is a robot dinosaur. If that's not cool, I don't know what is. So some of the dinosaurs have tech versions, like you can get a tech raptor, a tech T-Rex, and all kinds of fun stuff. So I'm probably gonna try to tame that guy. Now, I'm gonna focus on building this episode, and once we're done building this base, I'm gonna run straight down there and see if I can add that to my dinosaurs, because it just looks cool. It's not any different than a regular parasaur, except for its awesome factor. So, we finally managed to extend these up here, and they are just about on the same height of this cliff. So I just ran back and got some more supplies. But as you can see, we're still having some snapping issues. This is red because it's too far away from a foundation support. Now I can snap one right there, but I need some more support here. So I just ran down to get some more water and some more supplies. So I'm gonna hop down on this little tiny nook right here and drop a support beam into the rock there. And it looks like it'll go right through the middle of that ceiling, and that should, perfect. Now we can actually build it out further. And I'm gonna try to get this last one to connect to the rock here. And if all goes well, perfect. I think that's gonna actually be close enough. Oh, hey, Pteranodon, nice. Let me check this guy out because, okay, he's not a super high level. If you see a good level Pteranodon next to you, it's not a bad idea to go ahead and tame it. You can't fly on it until something like level 38, but if you keep it in your team all the way up until then and you can keep it alive, you're actually gonna have a really high level and strong Pteranodon by the time you can actually fly on it. So I am extending out these ceilings as far as I can, and I'm trying to line them up directly with the ones that I have down on the ground. So there's a foundation down on the ground right there, and then I'm putting the ceilings directly above them. Oh, perfect. So I was getting dehydrated, but now that it's raining, you can actually drink the rain, and now my water gauge is full. You can also pull out a water skin if you have it, and then use it on your hotbar, and it will fill up with water while it's raining. So that's very handy. And we're back with more supplies. As you can see, we're getting really close to that first support pillar that we built. It would have been smarter probably to build out from the edge there and then build in this direction, but you know, I had to line it up with the edge of the cliff, so that's why that was worth doing. So I'm gonna see if I can get this pillar one more higher, and that should be just perfect. Now that's very close to the level of these ceilings, and now I can snap a ceiling to it. If I hit the top right bumper, it's actually going to cycle between snap points. And as you can see here, I can actually extend this base out three wide in both directions. So I'm gonna hit the top right bumper, which will snap it down to the snap it to the support there instead of snapping to the ceiling, which means they're all now connected. So if you look here, this is bouncing up and down, and I'm actually going to just connect all of these foundations, and they're all on the same level. So I'm making these two foundations thick because if anything were to break one of these foundations and break the chain, anything in between would actually be possible to break. So that'll give it just a little bit more strength using the wood foundations. And now I'm gonna come over here. We've got the, we've connected all the pillars. And so now I can build to the right and left. And I'm gonna make this about 4 long and 3 deep. And this is gonna be a decent sized starter base. Now we can probably put most of the structures that we need in the base at this point, and I'll build out a little further in this direction too. Now if we wanna extend our base to make it bigger, we can just make the foundations below us a little bit bigger, which will allow us to make the top bigger. So we're just going to finish this out here, and one more should actually complete it. So now we have a 4x3 base that is basically floating up in the air, and we've used thatch to make the top part, which is very cheap and easy to make. So at this point, we've got a great foundation to build our first starter base, and we'll jump into the next episode when we build the rest of this base. So thanks so much for watching. I hope this was helpful, and we'll show you the rest of this really soon. Thanks so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more great guides like this one. Ark is an amazing game, but there is so much to learn before you can really enjoy it. We are dedicated to bringing you high-quality guides, tutorials, and Let's Play videos that are fun, helpful, clean, and suitable for the entire family. There's a tutorial in this series for everything we have done so far in this video. Check out these playlists for more episodes from this series and other guides to help you enjoy your journey on Ark.